This is the old prospector at Butterfield Stage Route. The route from St. Louis to San Francisco was a little more than 2,800 miles and typically required 23 to 24 days. That's averaging about 5 miles an hour.
We're out in the desert today, and if you'll notice what we call the Big Brown Mountain, that would be a mountain of trash. And so why would this be here, this reconstruction of a Butterfield stage stop right here in the middle of absolutely nowhere? Today we're on a fascinating journey, because out here in the middle of these mountains, at one time you would have saw ancient tribes gathering, hunting and gathering. You would have saw Spaniards later, and you would have saw Mesoamericans. You'd have seen Butterfield stagecoaches. You would have seen the Oatman family come through here. They would have come down this very trail. And they have built this recreation of the Butterfield stage stopping station. Now, we're going to be traveling down the Butterfield stage road right through here where those towers are, and we're going to be working this today, and we're going to go see where ancients walk before us. And so we're in this little area by the dump. If you ever went to Gila Bend, you would pass by the dump many a time, but most people don't realize that this is here. This little park, if you want to call it that, but it's really a fascinating place. It is the Butterfields station, regional facility of waste management, and they just put this up here. It's kind of a reminder of our past, which part of it's really kind of cool. I'm glad they did that. And the other part's kind of weird to me. So I'm kind of, you know, I'm glad it's here, but it's pretty incredible. But this is the trail of the Butterfield stage.
The passengers crammed together as they were, carried their luggage on their laps with mail pouches beneath their feet. Travel on stage was a brutal 24/7 ordeal. Only a few brief moments at way stations to stretch and get some terrible food. They suffered sleep deprivation, dust and heat in the summer, fighting cold rain in the winter. The price for this misery was $200, about $3,000 in today's money. But amazingly, they all got to their destinations alive. Who'd have figured?
We're going to go down an ancient trail today. We're going to hopefully visit some ancient ruin sites. Hopefully we're going to visit the trails that the Oatmans and everybody that went west went down. We're looking down this trail right there. That should take us to the Mormon Battalion Christmas Camp, and that's where we're going to head today. You know, the history of this area is going to be absolutely fascinating. It's going to be incredible today, and I can't wait to get on it. This is going to be a lot of fun. So we're going to be going down this valley. There's where we are, the Butterfield Stagecoach. There's the Brown Mountain. If we walk through here, this vast desert. Full battery? Oh, I gotta take one thing off here. Look at how beautiful that is, man. Sometimes you just gotta stop and look at where you're at and go, wow, look how beautiful that is right there. Man, that is incredible. I don't know why the beauty of those rocks and the trees just are unbelievable. How cool is that? Wow. You know, this is no different than it was when the Spanish came through here, or the Oatmans, or any of the amount of people going to the West Coast to strike it rich in the gold, and the outlaws and the cowboys. This is exactly as it was. There's not too many places in the world that you can go back to being in the exact, and in a sense, you're time traveling. Look at this. Now, we know the Mormon battalion camp is right on that point, right back in there somewhere, right in here. So if we wind around here, you know, I just had to stop because I'm overwhelmed by how beautiful this is. This is just gorgeous. And I'll tell you what, already, you know, we're only in May, but the desert is gorgeous. But man, it's getting hot already. Wow. Officially running out of breath. Take a hike back through here. I'm gonna not try to trailblaze. I'm gonna try to find a trail. Well, that wasn't a very good job. So let's go try over here. Didn't want to go right through that, but I should have. So this definitely looks like somebody's been walking through it. Boy, these river bottoms are horrible. Always have been, always will be. So here we are. That's going to be thick trying to get through there. We might have to find a different path to get through this. First thing I'm going to look at is any tracks. Anybody else blaze through here? No. That's not good. That means this is probably not your best shot. But you never know. We hope that Art has his ways to get out of here dialed in. But boy, it's no different than being on the Gila and not being able to get right over there. But it will come out somewhere. There will be a trail out of here somewhere. There always is. What do you think, Art? Isn't it a bitch when you're only right there and you're like, do I just bonsai it or do I try to be smart? Well, this looks like it's going away. You didn't think they had jungles in Arizona? Think again. This is incredible. Who had ever dreamed this? Well, you know, this means they have a lot of water here. So the good thing is, first thing I'm seeing is the ancients, would they have been here? Yes, absolutely they've been here. Because this is where the water's at. No tracks in the creek. So that means they didn't go through the creek. Anybody else has been here, if there's been anybody. That's not happening. That might. So, only thing it looks like it's been coming through here is about 3 to 4 feet tall. Coyote, aka mountain lion. You know, even your simplest journeys you think are going to be cake are not cake. They're Art's found an opening. He thinks, well, yeah. And I think he's actually right. What are you thinking, Art? Is that the play?
There's a game trail. I just heard something rustling. I gave it a chance to settle down. Yeah, it's through.
Well, here it is. No, he didn't go that way. This way. Yeah. Tell you what, that was a little bit of work getting through that dog. It's kind of a shame. Got a couple guys right there. Who had ever even got out here to see this? Who had ever known this was here? Holy smokes. It's an old sign too. Can't imagine anybody tearing it up. Means there's gotta be more. There's gonna be more than just that. For that, look at that jungle we just came through. There's our tall tree to remember to make sure we can get out of here. Well, I would have thought there'd been more than that. Maybe I'm wrong. Came in on right there. Bike should be right down there through this brush. A brush. There's one more though. So we are seeing something coming up this ridge. Is this something on this rock? If it is, it's hard to tell. Tell you, like I said, it's May and it is cooking already, and we're fairly early still. Fairly early. It's like something beat off the rock up here. You know, if I had to guess, I'd say that Christmas camp is right there. There's a point I want to check out because it's a point, and this would have been the bed, so the water would have flowed that way. It goes to point to point. That's why we do see that people were here. And then going to check that point out. We're kind of working in reverse. We were going to come to this last, but I'm glad we did today. I'm glad we just went ahead because this should be the hardest part, but you never know. We're going to look around down there to see if there's anything hanging out. We know there is a road that goes through, so we know we can get across there somewhere. There it is right there. There's the road. Well, going down is as easy as anything, so as long as you take one step at a time, you don't fall. With two hands, you know, none of this is that difficult with two hands, other than I've committed this one. Wouldn't kind of come back. Be the only shade you get right here. It's just so funny to stumble into a location and see that sign, knowing that they had spots, but you know, for a few petroglyphs that they've got, unless there's some village down here, I don't see it. Why? Now you stumble in these little guys like that right there, and but I don't see a large cropping of any of this stuff. It's just blowing my mind. I would think that if you see one, and again, if the sign wasn't here, it wouldn't be that weird. But because there's a sign there, I would think there'd be more stuff than that. And again, this might be archaeology stuff, because there it is, telling us up this way, right? That's what it's saying. Yeah. Well, let's just walk this ridge line. Kind of see if there's anything more. I mean, there's a path somebody's walked right there. Maybe more people come to this than I think. Okay, let's find our way back out of here. Look around out here in the field a little bit and get through here. Okay, let's find our way back out of here. Look around out here in the field a little bit and get through here. Well, there.
Term is the tank. It's called North Tank, and then the things on the other side of it. All right, I'll do it.
Oh, that wasn't bad. I don't know why. Better shut up. Here we go again. Right there. Here it is, right here. 1846 to 1848. Would have been a lot of stuff going on then. They would have been moving towards Oatman that way. And everybody would have been coming down this trail, heading to the promised land. Pretty incredible. We're here in their camp area. Right through here. If you look right over that point, that's where we're at in this valley. Started the day right through here. We came to this Mormon battalion. You know, one thing that sounds funny is that this came across this, you know, when we were looking at that sand going, oh shit. Imagine what the horses felt like when they were pulling them wagons. They saw that sand. I'm sure they were like, oh my God. We don't have to go down this trail, do we? Thank God for Boy Scouts to do this kind of stuff. I thought there used to be a book out here somewhere. Hell, see how far stop number whatever it is. Yeah. I'm going to have the camera on, Art, because this could be interesting. It looks deep as shit. Hey, don't forget to turn your bike on. Hey, you know what? Had a long, good day today, but I think it's time to get on these bikes and take that hour ride home and get back to the truck. You know, we stumbled on a shooting range here. Got a beers. Got a cooler. That looks like an old Coke cooler. That's old Black Widow's Coke cooler right there. Black Widow. Well, here it is. Black Widow left the cooler out here. Got no shooting range. Age of 2000, SL was out here. Now here we are right by where we were. So they didn't walk in here. So we gotta be on the right path. Like I said, they didn't walk out here. You know, I don't have the desire to ride 15 miles of this shit. I don't know about you. I mean, if it's
anything out there?
Well, there's supposed to be the pass, the Butterfield Pass. See if you can see it. Nice fault, good to fall. I'm down to 3 bars. So it is time to go home. Thank you.
That hurts.
Yeah, it does.